Recording in progress.
चेष्मा जी, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन। विल कलेक्टिवली प्रणाम रेसा कुंडली एंड तिखा बंधन। Fit both palms together. We humbly ask permission from Shmataji. Shmataji, please grant us permission to perform this morning meditation. Please guide us through this meditation to grow our depth in our scent, in our divinely knowledge. To be able to expand our heart and to be more collective. And to go beyond thoughtless awareness state. We'll recite the Maha Mantra followed by the Ganesh Mantra and we'll go into meditation.
Lakshmi Maha श्री गणेश मंत्र ओम त्वमेव साक्षात् श्री गणेश साक्षात् श्री आदिशक्ति माताजी श्री निर्मला दे
We'll meditate for a while. The attention on Sahasrara. Let us watch Manas Darshan.
Also, these organized religions, these monotheistic organized religions, started taking to course of gaining power or gaining money, because they thought that's the only way you can control people and can go on. They were least bothered as to deliver the goods, whatever have been described in the Bible. Bible, of course, was tampered very much and has been a lot of changes in that. And a person like Paul and Peter, who joined together, tried to spoil most of the truth. Though Quran was not so much touched, but still is dealt more with the right side, with the reproduction system and all those things. And so many things are still ambiguous. Now, simultaneously, two things have happened. I don't know if you are aware of it or not. First thing that has happened is that now we have a new science of microbiology, in which we have discovered that every cell has got a DNA tape. Every cell has got a program in it. As we have in a computer a chip, every cell has got a tape in it, in a way that it is programmed. And according to that program, the development takes place. Now imagine the intricacy of the whole thing. So many computers are already programmed. And all these cells have these in them. So a very mysterious sort of thing has come up before the scientist, and they cannot explain it. They cannot explain many things. But one of them is this. Now, what Sahaja Yoga has done, that it has proved that it is the will of God, it is the desire of God, the will of God, which is doing all the work. And it has been proved. All this Chaitanya, Adi Shakti, is nothing but the will of God. And will of God is the one is working out everything very harmoniously. I don't know if some of you must have read my book, first book, where I have described how this earth was created. There was a bang, but it was very harmonious. And how it developed is through the will of God. So everything was done in a way that God's will was working. Now the will of God you are feeling on your fingertips. After realization, now you have discovered the absolute science, which is the will of God, which is an absolute science. You people know that we have cured people of through Sahaja Yoga. You also know giving bandhan and all that things work out. So many things work out automatically after realization that people don't want to believe. In the beginning, people would not believe when the scientist told them something. But now it is, you can see the science is always in the flux, all the time changing. One theory is again challenged, another theory is again challenged. But Sahaja Yoga has exposed you to that great truth of science which cannot be challenged, which is all there. So anybody who comes out with any new proposal about defaming God or saying that there is no God, we can prove. Not that there is God, but everything, the creation of this earth, the creation of human beings and everything was done harmoniously by the will of God. If will of God has done everything, the human beings should not take any credit for discovering some things which are created by God. Supposing this carpet is made by somebody and we start discovering all the colors, what is so great? It is all there. You cannot create. So it is not the creation part of it so much important, but the fashioning of this world, whole thing, was done by the will of God. Now, if the will of God is so important, it has to be proved. And now through Sahaja Yoga, after the breaking of the Sahasrara, you have now for the first time felt the will of God, which is such an important thing. But for us, it is come to us so sahaj that we don't understand. We just give the bandhan and the things work out. And we feel that the things have worked out. So it is bandhan which has worked out. And we have managed everything. It's not so. It's much more than that. We have now become part and parcel of that big computer, of that will of God. We have become the medium, or we can say the channels of that will of God. We are connected with that will of God which created all this universe. So everything we can manage because we have got the absolute science in our hand. The absolute science which will work out the betterment of the whole world. We can prove it to the scientist that there is a will of God which has done all this creation. Even evolutionary process is the will of God. Without his will, nothing could have happened. So many people used to say that not and a blade of grass moves without the will of God, which is a very true thing. And you have seen now that the will of God we have got as our own power. We can use it. So how important it is to be a Sahayogi. Perhaps we don't realize how important it is to be a Sahayogi. Sahayoga is not only for saying, Mother, I'm full of joy, I'm enjoying myself, I got purified, everything is fine. But for what? Why did you get all these blessings? Why you have been cleansed so that this knowledge of will of God should be apparent in you? Not only that, should be a part and parcel of you. So we have to raise our level. We have to come up. For mediocre and ordinary people, it is really useless to give them Sahayoga because they are good for nothing. They are not going to help us in any way, because what is needed is now today that we should have people who can really manifest and reflect the will of God. And for that, you can understand, we have to have very strong people, because this will has created this whole universe, the cosmos, this Mother Earth. Everything is created by this will of God. So now we are exposed to a new dimension, and that dimension is that we are ones who are channels of that will of God. So then, what is our duty? And what should we do about it? So the omnipotent God, who is everywhere, who has done all this, the will of God that has worked it out, has to work through you people. And you have to be very strong, very sensible, very wise, also very effective people. The more effective you become, the more energy you will get. But still I feel that the Sahayogis are more not taking the responsibility of understanding that they have to represent this God Almighty, who is omnipresent, omniscient, who knows everything, who sees everything, and who is potent, means almighty. If you understand that this is what has happened after opening the Sahasrara, that you have now got the power which has these three qualities in it. Say, now this big thing has to be supported by strong pillars. But supposing if they are not strong, it will fall down. In the same way, such a great power which has come to you. For that we don't need very successful people. We don't need people who have a big name or those who have lots of money. What we need, people of character, people of understanding, of wisdom, and of strength, that whatever may come, I will stand by it. I will take to it. I'll cope with it. I'll change myself and improve myself. So now illusion has been dispelled. I hope you all have got rid of your illusions. Also, you should have no illusions about yourself. If you have any illusions, you should leave Sahayoga. But know that you are chosen for this purpose by God's will. That's why you are here. And you have to take it up, the responsibility of understanding this science, which is absolute, and working it out yourself, for yourself as well as for others. You have felt my love. But your love must be felt, because God is love. So your love must be felt by others. Others must feel that you are compassionate, loving, understanding. That's all the time this will of God is flowing through you. And you have to work it out in such a manner that people should know that you are a saint, that this power is flowing through you. So now, as you are today here, so many people, I'm really enamored to see so many people are there. And we have done so much of our growth and grown out of all those nonsensical things that we were following. But today, we have to take a vow that I'll now fashion my life according to the will of God. Absolutely. And dedicate myself to that. No family, no other considerations, just forget it. Nothing so important. Everything can be looked after by the will of God. So if you just try to follow the will of God, your children will look looked after, everything will be looked after. You don't have to worry for anything. And that works. Just try to understand that you have problems because you don't want to give those problems to God. You want to keep it to themselves. That's why you have problems. If you decide that, no, I just want to give these problems to the God's will, finished. Also, there are some who want to say that we are not so capable, whether we can't do it. Saying like this also is stupid. You test yourself. See for yourself. So first of all, one has to understand, why do we say such a thing? Maybe that we are very money-oriented, that we want to have money to ourselves or something like that. Or some people are there who talk of business also in surgery. There must be something like a money orientation or some sort of a material attachment that they say that we are not capable, we cannot change. The second could be this mamatva, as they call it, the attachment, your family, children, this, that. Or this is mine, this is mine, this is mine. This could be the second reason that you think that you are not bold enough or you are not strong enough to do such. Thirdly, could be that you are still playing with your old habits and that you are enjoying your life without virtues. There can be some reason like that. So just try to look in. Why am I behaving like this? Why am I not getting into the same beautiful path of my ascent as everybody has got it? If we introspect, we'll find out that there's something wrong with me that I think I'm not capable of doing. You are capable of doing everything. You just try this and enjoy it. So most important thing now remains is that you should become a proper, strong, compassionate vehicle of God's will. So, then what is most important? Of course, I agree that you do my puja because that helps you a lot, no doubt. But other things are not important. So many other things you people tell me is not of importance. Main thing is that you should all ascend higher and higher and compete with each other in getting into higher situation. As it is, I think in such a short time we have achieved a lot, no doubt. But still we have to speed up and work it out. I'm sure that this new science, or we can say which is the absolute science, will one day outshadow the other science and tell people that this is what it is. It is in your hands. You work it out. So today is the day we celebrate by which we have opened absolutely a new dimension. Absolutely a venue of great divinity, of the proofs of divine. And this is something so great that we can really finish all the illusions they have about themselves, about their ego. We can manage that. That power you all have. May God bless you.
We'll continue to meditate. Shamad ji, thank you for giving us permission for this morning meditation. Thank you for all your divine blessings for bringing us together for this collective meditation. By your grace, may we all be able to express divine love from within us. And to be able to stay stronger in our collective. May we now raise your kundalini and take your bandhan. Thank you, everyone. Have a good day. Jai Shmat Ji.